Hi. In this video we are going to show you how to rotate a turntable using the MECHA C2 controller. If you bought the MECHA C2 controller separately, then it's easy to use it to rotate a turntable. You also need a battery holder, which comes with a built-in cable for connecting to the DC power input port of the controller. We are using a MECHA dual battery holder bottom to bottom, but you can choose another model, depending on how you want to attach it to the tripod. The attachment strap allows you to attach it in several ways. It may be more convenient to attach it to a tripod leg, in some cases. Then you need a rotator, which can be E1, E2, or P1. We are using an E2 here, but the E1 is an equally good choice, being much quieter. The MECHA P1 rotator has virtually no backlash and is very quiet, but it is also bulkier and heavier. The controller controls the rotator, so they need to be connected. You can use either the lower cable or the upper cable of the controller for this purpose. In C2's config menu, but also in the config page, there is a setting that you should check and change, if necessary, depending on the cable used. To understand this setting more easily, you should know that in dual-axis applications, the rotator connected to the controller via the lower cable is rotator 1. And the rotator connected to the controller via the upper cable is rotator 2. Going back to the turntable, if you are using the lower cable to connect the controller to the rotator, the setting must be rotator 1 is down, meaning the rotator 1 and C2 controller are connected via the lower cable. If you are using the upper cable, change the setting to rotator 1 is up, which means the rotator 1 and C2 controller are connected via the upper cable. Since we only have one rotator, the setting for rotator 2 will be ignored. If you bought a package like F9922 dual axis MECHA C2E2E2 with NN6 and nadir adapter, it means that you should use the controller and the upper rotator. After disassembling the product, mount the rotator on the tripod and attach the controller to its central column. They are already connected via the upper cable and cannot be disconnected. Therefore, the config option mentioned earlier must be rotator 1 is up in this case. Our object turntable is a disc of 10-inch diameter designed to be mounted on our advanced rotators, but also on MECHA rotators. It includes a mounting kit, and you can buy separately a set of 5 velvet covers: red, white, blue, black and green. Now place the object you want to film or photograph on the turntable. This is our MECHA controller C1 with rotator E1, which can also be used to rotate a turntable. If you want to photograph the object, you need to plug the right shutter cable for the camera in use into the C2's camera port to allow the triggering of the shutter automatically. All you have to do now to rotate the turntable is to launch a preset or press certain buttons on the controller. Let us quickly create some presets. For more details, we recommend that you watch the video about presets based on shooting positions for MECHA C2. Example 1. For 12 shots around, the first setting should be 12 sh. SH alternates with auto and focal length. Use the up arrow button to find SH. And use the minus or plus button to adjust the value. There will be one camera trigger signal per position. The duration of the shutter button signal is half a second. Zero, zero, zero means one row at 0 degrees tilt. This is a normal setting if you use only one rotator, as in our case. If you use a second rotator, for example to tilt the camera, then it makes more sense to set different tilts, which means rows at different tilts. You will connect the controller to the second rotator using the cable that we are not using now. The upper rail position when launching this preset should be horizontal, or level, even if there is no upper rail, for efficiency reasons. Leave the direction of rotation unspecified if you want to specify it when launching the preset. The question mark means unspecified. The next setting we want to find is zenith and nadir shots. The down arrow button can be used to navigate faster, skipping some settings. No need for zenith and nadir shots. So we have to find this value. And we will leave all other settings unchanged. Now you can press the center button to save the preset. Press this button again to launch the preset. When the OLED display shows set position, use the left or right arrow button to change the initial view, if needed. Press the center button to confirm the change. Then specify the direction of rotation, if it is not specified in the preset, as in our case. We have pressed the left arrow button, so the rotation is to the left, since the setting for horizontal rotation is the default in our case. If the direction of rotation is not specified, the advantage is that you can use the same preset for rotation in the opposite direction. As before, press the center button to launch the preset, and once more to confirm the position, then specify the direction of rotation. If you set zero camera trigger signals, T0, the stop in each shooting position will be very short. Example 2. Instead of modifying the previous preset, you can create a new one. The previous preset is used as a template for the new preset. For 72 shots around, just set 72SH instead of 12SH. Let us specify the direction of rotation to the left, this time. Press the center button to save the preset. Press it again to launch the preset. And use the same button to confirm the position. For testing purposes, you can set the number of camera trigger signals to -1, T-1. The preset will be executed as usual, except that the trigger signals will not be sent. Example 3. Simple rotations can also be used to rotate a turntable. For a 360-degree rotation, set an interval 3 of 360 degrees, or one turn. So find the interval 3 option in the config menu. To enter edit mode, press the plus button. Then use the plus or minus button to adjust the value. Press and hold the button to speed up the adjustment. After 359, notice that one turn follows, not 360 degrees. Press the center button to confirm the change. The display shows set position, which means you can use the arrow buttons to perform simple rotations without accessing simple rotations. Left and menu to rotate the turntable to the left, or right and menu to rotate the turntable to the right. Press power to skip this step. You can similarly adjust the speed corresponding to interval 3. We recommend that you test different values and find the right value for your needs. For filming, you may need a lower speed. After pressing the center button, you can test the speed by performing a few simple rotations, or you can press the power button to skip this step. Now go to simple rotations and press the left button, then menu button. You may have noticed that we usually use MECHA in simple mode, not in advanced mode. As a result, we need to access simple rotations to be able to perform rotations using the arrow buttons. For a 360-degree rotation in the opposite direction, press the right button, then the menu button. The menu button should be pressed quickly after pressing the left or right button. Example 4. We have already mentioned, for changing the initial view, or for small rotations, in simple rotations, press and hold the left arrow button, or right arrow button. Example 5. For 1000 turns continuously, go back to the interval 3 option and adjust the current value using the right button, which increases the value 10 times with each press. Use the center button to confirm the change. You can always press the power button to skip the set position step. Also change the rotation speed, if necessary. Then, in simple rotations, press the right button, then the menu button, to rotate the turntable to the right. The rotation stops after 1000 turns, or when the batteries are completely discharged. You can also press the power button on the controller to cancel the rotation currently in progress. Power supply can be used for continuous operation if necessary. Thank you for watching.